Hello, today for review I've got four interesting models of earphones made by Japanese company Radius. They create wide range of IEMs starting from pretty entry level and up to $400 models with interesting piezo and dynamic driver combo. But I will start from relatively inexpensive models and will move up to more expensive ones. So first models that I've got for review, it is model NEF21K. It is relatively inexpensive model. It's a price about $50. It depends on country and so on, but it is average price. As you can see, they are packed in interesting transparent plastic case. It open from this side if you pull this carefully. You can unwrap them and get access to internals. Pretty interesting packaging. So with them you will have some papers, manuals, two pair of spare tips, and that's pretty much it. So let's pull them out. For Radius it is inexpensive model, so accessory set is a bit limited. As you can see, they're made of good plastic. Build quality is pretty nice. They have this the proprietary ear tips in this interesting shape. They're made of plastic, as I've said before. They are small and they are very comfortable. They're lightweight and they fit into almost any ears. There is strain relief to protect the cable. Cable is absolutely simple. It is silicone isolated. It goes down to jack and jack is angled. So build quality is pretty fairly simple, but it is nice for this price range. Sound is also pretty simple. There is nothing fancy in their sound. Mids are resolving with average resolution. Bass isn't accented, they are a bit bright. Treble is simple, so it is fairly simple price for those who don't like to lot of lower frequencies and accent on lows. So it is a fairly simple sound for some not complex music, but anyway you can listen to them if you like. Next model, it is NEF31. It costs about the same as previous one and packaged in the same way, but actually it offers a bit different sound tuning. So it opens the same way, you unwrap and you will have access to the accessory set. So also two pair of tips, some papers, and that's all. So build is absolutely same. Radius has this earphones in three different colors, so you can choose one that you like the most. Same nice tips, same two levels of deepness, so you can select better fit for you. So same level of comfort and sound isolation, but this earphones are interesting for those who like a lot of lower frequencies. They have accented lows and they sound pretty good, especially on pop music, on electronic music. It's not bloated, it's not muddy, but it's pretty aggressive and sounds fun sometimes. They bleed a little bit on the mids, but not that much. So they offering nice V-shaped signature with bigger accent on lows and not so big accent on treble, but without too much, without exceeding the limits of normal sounding. So it is, I think this model is more interesting than 21st model, because this will definitely fit the tastes of those who like low frequencies and limited on build on money. So for this $50 or $60 you will have pretty fun sounding bass head model with normal bus, pretty fast with good resolution, and so on and so forth. MIDs are also on the level of the 21st model, but it's okay for this model because it offers more fun sounding. And now we are moving to more expensive models. So NHR21, it is a more pricier model from Radius. Their price is a bit less than $200. Usually you can find them for $175 or so. As you can see, package is fancier. It's now made of cardboard, so and looks more expensive. If we unwrap this, here is earphones themselves. Here are some manuals, warranty cards, but accessory set is also limited. So now you will have three pair of tips, but it's pretty much the same. So this model, as you can see, looks much more fancier. It has unusual shape, pretty stylish. It's still made of plastic, but now it looks much more interesting. There is also red version, so you can select red or black one. Same comfortable ear tips, same two level of deepness, but different design. Cable now is fabric coated, so it's more reliable and more durable, and as you can see, jack is much fancier this time. Sonically, I can say that it is the most balanced and most natural model in all Radius lineup. This is the model for those who like most uncolored sound from this Japanese company. They still have good lower frequencies, very fast, very punchy and energetic, but without accent on them. Nice resolving mids, not super resolving, but much better than less expensive models. So they have a better sound stage, of course. It's above average in width and in depth, and good layering. Treble is non-fatiguing but well defined. Not superb, but really good for now for this price range. So actually it is universal model for classical music, for some kinds of metal, for rock music, and it is interesting option for those who look for something stylish. As you can see, they look really great and offer nice, interesting, pretty balanced sound with good resolution, without accents on some frequencies, and so on. They are also very comfortable, so I can recommend them. And the most expensive model in this review, it is NIHR31. It costs about $250 up to $300, depends on country and shop. And it offers interesting sound tuning. So same box as NHR21. It also opens pretty easily. But this time you will have better accessory set. You will have carrying pouch, short clip, and three pair of extra tips. As you can see, design is close to 21st model, but this one features replaceable cables. Here used common MMCX connector with pretty good quality, so you can replace cable, try balanced connection, and so on and so forth. So actually it is good feature for high-end IEMs, so you can experiment with cables, try different options and other stuff like that. Same ear tips, same level of comfort, they are very comfortable, I can say. Same stylish design, they also exist in red color and in other colors. but these ones are also have accent on lower frequencies. Actually, sonically they remind me much more expensive and very popular Campfire Audio Andromeda. They have pretty similar tuning with accent on lower frequencies, with good resolution and speed, and a bit rolled off mids and accent on treble to compensate lower frequencies. Of course, they sound simpler than Vega because they cost few times less, but actually interesting model for those who like lower frequencies with electronic music, with styles like techno, with pop, rap and so on, and other styles like that, that sound really good. They also superb for jazz music because they offering this warm foundation for the music. Very interesting sound. So mids are a bit rolled off, but has nice resolution. They are not smooth, not actually primitive. Bass is pretty fast with good attacks. Not the punchiest one, but very, very good. And treble is also pretty detailed. It adds a bit sparkle, adds a bit air. So if you like colored sound signature, it is the model of very interesting model for you to consider. And replaceable cables allows interesting experiments. So this is also very interesting model in Radius lineup. So here is four popular models by Japanese company Radius. I've tried to show them to you. Also, I made their most expensive model review some time ago. I will put a link into the description. Thank you for attention.